What some people call income elasticity, I'm going to call income elasticity of demand, because then we can follow our formula that applies to every elasticity. Remember, we have a percentage change in quantity divided by a percentage change in something else, and the name of the elasticity is going to tell us what we put in for the quantity and what we put in for the something else. This is the same setup as a percentage change in the impulse. The thing that is causing us to change our behavior is the impulse, and the response is what we do because of that impulse. For income elasticity of demand, remember the first word, whatever comes before elasticity is going to the bottom. That is our impulse. And whatever comes after the word of is the quantity that we want in the numerator. Now, I know demand is not a quantity, but we do have a quantity associated with it that's quantity demanded. This tells us what happens to quantity demanded if income increases by 1%. So this is a fraction. If we put it over 1, then whatever number we get here for the elasticity is going to be the percentage change in quantity demanded. We have a little nomenclature, and I'm going to make a table. And I like to think of my income going up. Let's go with income increases by 1%. Now, if this elasticity is less than 0, what that means is the numerator has to be negative. That means I get more money, but I'm buying less stuff. And those are inferior goods. All right, so you got more money, but you're buying less of it because they kind of suck. When elasticity is greater than 0, that means you get more money and you buy more of that good. And that happens with most goods. In fact, it's so common, we call those goods normal goods. Now, normal goods are divided into two categories. You have an elasticity between 0 and 1, and you have an elasticity greater than 1. So when the elasticity is between 0 and 1, we're going to call those necessity goods. And when the elasticity is greater than 1, we call those luxury goods. So examples of inferior goods are things like ramen noodles. I'm not saying that nobody likes ramen noodles, but often we just buy them when we don't have a ton of money. Right? Bus fare is an inferior good because when people's income goes down, they get rid of a car, they take the bus more. Right? Generic brands a lot of times are perceived as not being as good, and so people often buy them when they don't have as much money. So when your income goes up, you switch away from generic brands and you buy name brands, and that's why they're inferior goods. So with normal goods, they're broken into two categories. So let's take a look at necessities. Bread, right? If my income doubles, I'm not going to eat twice as much bread. I'll eat maybe a little bit more bread. In fact, maybe I'll buy a little bit more bread and end up wasting a bit more of it. But things like eyeglasses, I'm not going to go out and buy twice as many eyeglasses if my income goes up. But luxury goods, we are going to see a big change. If my income goes up by 1%, I'm going to buy more than 1% extra of things like artwork, name brands. Here I made a little visual representation. I have a number line that represents the income elasticity of demand. And there's this cutoff at 0. Anything to the left of that, you have negative numbers, and those are inferior goods. You have positive numbers on the right, and anything between 0 and 1, you have necessities, and then luxuries greater than 1. Another way of thinking about these rules is that if the signs of the change are opposite, so one rises and the other one falls. In our previous example, we just said the income went up by 1%, and then we wanted less stuff, so we had a negative change divided by a positive, that gave us a negative number. However, if your income falls, then you're going to end up buying more inferior goods. However, if your income falls and you buy fewer goods, well, those are normal goods. Now we can break normal goods down into two categories. So I have percentage change in quantity demanded is less than the change in income in absolute value terms. What that means is, say, if your income goes up by 10% and your consumption only goes up by 1%, that would be a necessity. But if your income goes up by 10% and your quantity demanded changes by 20%, that would be a luxury. So I want you to be careful with the word luxury in this class. If you want to say something is a luxury, I really need you to be sure that you are talking about an income elasticity that is greater than 1. I once did an example with a student where he talked about some changes in his life with income and consumption. He bought a Rolex, and it turns out that his Rolex watch was a necessity good, according to these calculations. So follow the calculations. Let's take one more look at income elasticity. When your income increases, you're going to buy fewer inferior goods. and you'll buy more normal goods. You buy a little bit more necessities and way more luxuries. Now notice, what do I mean by that? So a little bit, that's relative to the change in income. So if my income changes by 5%, 2% is less than that, that's a bit. But 9%, that's more than 5, so that would be a lot. Now the good news is, if you know this for an income increase, it's just opposite of that for an income decrease. So if your income goes down, you buy more inferior goods, you buy fewer normal goods. You can only cut back on your necessities a little bit, but you can cut way back on your luxuries, right? If your income goes way down, you can stop going out to eat, you can stop buying new artwork, but you can't stop buying food.